Hi friends, in this video we will discuss the second part of the area acoustic modeling, that is Fox-William-Hawking model. So you can see on the screen, this is the equation that would be solved along with the Navier-Stokes equation, continuity equation. So this equation has been derived from the combination of both Navier-Stokes and continuity equation. So this is an acoustics equation, and here you can see that P prime, which is called sound pressure or acoustic pressure, so which is a indirect indication of the level of the sound at any point. And these UI, VN, all those indicates the velocity components along the normal direction to the surface as well as to the flow. So this equation would be solved between the source and the receivers, what we mentioned in the tool or in the fluent. I'll just show the tutorial how we will mention the source and the receiver. So actually in any sound propagation, we need to have a source as well as a receiver to predict what is the amount of sound that is being received at the receiver end. So compared to the broadband model, where only the formula has been interpreted with respect to the turbulent kinetic energy and turbulent dissipation, but in this Fox model, it's not that way. It tries to solve the equation and it will give the pressure signals at the different receivers, what we mention inside a tool. So it is very important for us to give the source and the receivers. In between that only this equation should be solved, which is not possible in the broadband noise model. So using this Fox-William model, you can it is helpful in detecting any cracks or any other shape irregularities. Everything you can you can detect using the Fox-William model. So it is with respect to the pressure. So if there is any cracks that has happened inside a wall or inside a plate, so the pressure signal, the sound signal, would be different compared to the point just beside the crack. So with respect to that pressure distribution or the pressure signal, sound pressure signal, you can easily detect whether there is a crack present inside the plate or not, or any point in specific. So I'll just show you a brief procedure how we need to follow. Yeah, you can see a screen here. So if you take this as your source, so if you can take this as your source, and these two points are receivers, so you need to mention. So I will take this entire mirror as my source and these two points are receivers. So the equation would be solved between the source and these two receivers, and remaining part the equation will not be solved. So that is the acoustic wave equation will not be solved in the remaining part. Here only it will solve. So it is very important for us to mention what is the source and what are the two receivers. So I have mentioned here two receivers, receiver one and receiver two, right? So if there is any crack present here, for example, if there is a crack present here, this is a crack, and if you have mentioned two points are receivers, one point is this, another point inside a crack. So when the equation is been solved between the source and these two receivers, so receiver one would have a different pressure signal compared to the receiver two, and depending on the depth of the crack, on the size of the crack, at point two the receiver signal would be much more varied. So with respect to that, you can confirm whether there is a crack present or not. So now I'll just make you to go through the fluent options. So it is same as such in the broadband noise model, except in the acoustic we need to mention Fox-William model, and I'm asking it to compute acoustic signal simultaneously. And then as defined sources, I have mentioned a mirror wall as my source. Click on apply, close, right? And in the data receivers, I have mentioned two points which I bought it from Space Climb. We just need mention any point inside this domain. I have mentioned only two points, receiver one and receiver two, and I'm clicking OK. Click on apply, OK. And same boundary conditions in which I have inlet is at 10 meters per second. click OK. Similarly, outlet, which is my opening or flow, and the wall as mirror wall and the side wall. This wall is also a wall boundary condition. And after that, you can just initialize. Click on initialize. I've already initialized. And in the run calculation, I've mentioned that this is my time step size. Number of time steps 1000. I've mentioned 10,000. Sorry. So you can increase the number of time steps also. Then just click on calculate. So after calculation, you just go to acoustic signals. So you can see here, this is your source term and these are to your receiver terms, right? So if you don't want to solve it simultaneously, you can also uncheck this and ask it to export. So it will not solve simultaneously. So after the Navier-Stokes equation, continuity equation, regular equations are solved, then again you need to solve for the acoustic signals by selecting this and this. You need to click on calculate. So then it will solve without solving simultaneously. But yeah, it would be easy if you try to solve it simultaneously. It is called on the fly model. On the fly means when the equations of the Navier-Stokes and continuity are being solved, the wave equation also will be simultaneously solved. So I'll just close this. I have ran for a few iterations. So then you just go to the post processing. So in the post processing, I'll just show you how we need to how the pressure signal or the how the sound pressure is being distributed at two receivers, at receiver one and receiver two. And I also show you, yeah, one second, I'll just show you. So this is my chart. Okay. In the chart, click on X-ray transient sequence, and in the data series, just go to look file, because we have already got the receiver files. So in the acoustics, in the Fluent, you will find those files. So just click on all files. So these are the receiver 1 and receiver 2. So click receiver 1, open, as well as select another series. Here also select other file, receiver 2 file. Receiver 2 file, click on open, then apply. So you can see here with respect to time how the pressure has been distributed, and you can see some lag is there. It was starting a bit before compared to this, because those two points I have selected not at the same level, but one is before, another one is after with respect to the mirror position. That's why there is a reason lag, and you can see there is a bit what can I say, attenuation of the signal. Here the pressure is high compared to the pressure here, because the signal has been attenuated or it has been decreased in length. And you can see negative pressure, negative this one, because I have just given it beside or behind the mirror where there is more negative pressure. So this is the distribution of the pressure with respect to time. I have selected, I have given only few time steps, that is only 0.1 second, which is very low. You can extend from your side if you require. So already I have given the case file in the previous broadband spectrum. You can just use that case file if you require. And I'll just show you how to use the fast Fourier transform. So in this fast Fourier transform, we have got the distribution with respect to time, how the sound pressure has been distributed. But instead of sound pressure distribution with respect to time, you can also have the variation with respect to frequency. So I mean, like when you check out here, so this is some sort of wave distribution with respect to time, right? So x-axis is time and y-axis can be pressure, anything. So that is a distribution of the pressure with respect to time. So this can be resolved as a combination of a proper and different amplitude sine and cosines with some phase difference getting overlapped. So when all these three, 1, 2, 3, when these three or 4 or 5, it can be a set of so many number of a proper signals that have been overlapped and which is producing this zigzagged fashion signal. So this zigzagged fashion signal is a combination of all this number of regular signals. So that would be resolved using the Fourier transform. So using these Fourier transforms, so we can resolve this into a combination of different sine and cosine waves and how that is been getting varied with respect to the frequency. So as I have shown here, each one has its own time period. So this is a time period for the first wave. This is a time period for second wave. This is a time period for the third wave, which is so different for each different wave. So for each different wave, we have got different time periods. So if anybody questions you, where does the maximum intensity of the power lies, or at what frequency, at what time period there is a maximum waves that are being overlapped? If anybody asks in that way, you can just check the fast Fourier transforms and click on apply. So now you can see here, so at this point, so it is very near to it may be like a 10. So at 10 frequency, at the frequency number 10 hertz, you can see maximum power has been distributed, right? So for both receiver 1 and receiver 2, you can see the blue line is receiver 1 and red line is receiver 2. Both has that maximum power spectral density, or the density of the waves amplitude are distributed majorly at the frequency of 10. So it is like 1 by 10 time period. 1 by 10 means it's like 0.1 second. So mostly is distributed here with respect to the frequency. So I have done it for only a few time steps. You can increase the time steps and you can check at what frequency that maximum power is being distributed, what time period. So indirectly it indicates the time period. So I hope this tutorial has helped you guys. So please do subscribe the video, and if you have any doubts or if you have any relative issues, you can comment in the comment section, and also you can contact me through the mail ID which I give in the description. Thank you.